Stop me and I'll send refugees. From Hagia Sophia to Libya, Erdogan is playing EU like a pro. The European Union is in the middle of a long-term crisis that could endanger the maritime security and territorial interests of Mediterranean countries like Italy and France. The man holding the EU by its neck is the wannabe Khalifa and the brand ambassador of extremist political Islam, Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan. Erdogan has checkmated the EU with a single extortionist tool. The Syrian war refugees and the intergovernmental organization is literally clueless on how to tackle the threat. Erdogan is hurting European countries and at the same time forcing them to cough up additional funds for containing the influx of refugees. Turkey is using the same strategy in the latest battlefield, Libya. Situated on the coast of the Mediterranean Sea, the North African country borders Europe and serves as a gatekeeper, preventing migrants from all over Africa who try to enter the European continent illegally. Erdogan is currently supporting the UN-backed Government of National Accord, that is the GNA, in the country. With Turkish support, the GNA has been making deep inroads against the rival Libyan National Army, LNA, led by General Khalifa Haftar. Haftar is being viewed as a better leader, while the GNA offers a highly Islamist regime. Countries like Italy that face the biggest threat of a huge refugee inflow from different parts of Africa, like the Maghreb region, the Sahel region, Western Africa and Eastern Africa via Libya, see Haftar as crucial in stemming the flow of Arabic and African refugees. To make matters worse, Erdogan has also decided to convert Hagia Sophia, the ancient era cathedral turned mosque turned museum, into a mosque all over again. This is a grave provocation to Christian nations with staunch Catholics and Orthodox Christians like Greece, France, Spain, Italy and Russia. Under normal circumstances, the EU should have gone berserk against Turkey in Libya, but Erdogan has a strong grip over the geopolitical situation. The Turkish president keeps exploiting the Syrian refugee situation. The Syrian civil war had created millions of refugees. According to UN estimates, around 13.5 million Syrian and other Middle Eastern refugees required humanitarian assistances as of 2016. Of these, around 6 million were internally displaced, while 5 million were cross-border refugees who sought asylum in other countries. An overwhelming majority of these refugees, that is 3.6 million to be precise, reside in Turkey in refugee camps. These 3.6 million refugees are holding the EU back. In 2016, Turkey reached an understanding with the EU wherein Ankara was bound to halt the flow of refugees in return of European aid. Erdogan has used them for blackmailing the EU for more aid and achieving his territorial ambitions time and again. Last year, when the Turkish forces and proxies went on a rampage during a military incursion into northeastern Syria in Kurdish-held lands and the European Union condemned its actions, Erdogan had threatened that he would open the floodgates of refugees towards Europe if the military actions was described as an invasion. He used this arm-twisting tactic again in March this year. This time around, Turkey was engaged in skirmishes in Syria with the Russia-backed Syrian forces. Erdogan, being a NATO member, wanted NATO allies to declare a no-fly zone in Syria. But the NATO did not come to his rescue. Erdogan retaliated and flooded thousands of refugees into the Greek and Bulgarian borders. In the Libya battle, Erdogan is again using the same form of extortion. Europe fears that Erdogan would unleash hundreds of thousands of refugees on the EU if they try to counter him in Libya. Countries like Italy and Germany are not playing any role in Libya. France is giving covert support to Haftar, who has strongholds in eastern Libya. However, Italy has turned against Paris over this reason. Officials in Rome claim that Macron's actions in Libya dash any hopes of a political situation. The EU is yet again divided over a key issue. The organization even tried to issue a statement condemning Haftar's westward offensive. France, however, blocked such attempts. Consequently, the EU is giving more money to Erdogan, who is trying to hurt them in every way possible. The Maghreb region, of which Libya is a part, is traditionally a region of competition between Italy and France, which also helps them in exercising complete influence over the Mediterranean. But this balance of power is shifting with Erdogan's forays in the region. A puppet regime in Libya, handled by Erdogan, will become another powerful tool to take Europe by ransom. Libya has always been in a position to milk money out of Europe. When Libyan leader Gaddafi was alive, he drew millions of US dollars out of Europe. In case the EU tried to back out, he would warn in crass language, Europe runs the risk of turning black from illegal immigration and it could turn into Africa. Now with Erdogan placing his own regime in Libya, he will start asking Europe to release even greater funds in order to hold back African refugees. Turkey in charge of Libya also means a threat to Mediterranean security. Turkey is inherently expansionist and has invaded parts of other countries like Cyprus, which it continues to occupy till date. Erdogan has caught the EU in an uncomfortable situation. He knows he can blackmail the bloc and do whatever he likes. Ultimately, he's going to push political Islam into Europe, while the EU seems witless, leaderless, and divided.